right, 11.5 here, exploring solids. This is the definition of a polyhedron. It is a solid that is bound by polygons that enclose in a single region of space. So these are all examples. Here's an example, there's an example. These are all examples of polyhedrons. Below are non-examples of polyhedrons. They have a rounded, they don't have an end. We know you can't have a cylinder or a sphere, a cone. All right, the face of a polyhedron are polygons. You already know what a polygon is. The edge is a line segment formed by the intersection of two faces. Like, this is an edge. This is an edge, right? That is an edge. And the face would be like this whole front side. That's a face, if you want to think about it like that. Then the vertex is a point where three or more edges meet. So that would be like the corners, right? Here's a vertex. Here's a vertex. There, you know, all the way around like that. It's important that you know what these are, then we have to calculate them. So I have four examples here. First off, let's figure out how many faces this figure has here. So faces. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then how many edges does it have? Remember, the edges are like the straight segment here in between the faces. So it has 12 edges. So 1, 2, 3, 4 on the top on these sides. That's 4 more. And then 4 on the bottom. And then vertices. How many corners does the polyhedron have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, that's all we're doing for right now, because we're going to talk about a fancy formula that we're going to use, but not at this point. All right, so let's move over here and find how many faces does this polyhedron have. So 1, the bottom and the side, that's 3, 4, 5. How many edges does it have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then how many vertices does it have? Right, how many corners? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright, moving to the bottom. How many faces does this fancy little figure have? Alright, so we got the top and the bottom or whatever, the pentagon. And then we have the sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 faces. How many edges? Alright, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And then how many vertices it has with this all my corners, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I probably didn't have to count that, but whatever it is. All right, last one over here. How many faces? Maybe pause the video and see if you can find the faces and the edges and the vertices. And there are 18 edges, what? And 12 vertices in this face of polyhedron. A regular polyhedron is a polyhedron whose faces are all congruent regular polygons. Remember, regular means equal sides, equal angles. So regular polyhedron, like a cube, is definitely a regular polyhedron. It's hard to tell it's a cube, maybe. When I'm standing up close to it, it looks really bizarre, but maybe from the distance it looks really bizarre. I guess we should add a camera. Something like that. I don't know. Yeah, whatever. Or it's like a TV video that's not showing. Alright, convex polyhedron. That any two points on its surface can be connected by the line segment that lies entirely inside of the polyhedron. Remember convex and concave, right? So convex means I can draw a straight line and I'm never going to enter the interior. See this little anvil down here? If I draw a straight line here, I'm inside, right? So that's concave. So not convex. It's interior. And if at any point I'm going too fast, you know, you can pause, rewind, write your definitions down, blah, blah, blah. Okay. A tetrahedron is a polyhedron with four faces. I'm not sure tetra, maybe that's Latin for four or something. I'm always trying to figure out where they come up with these words. An octahedron, that makes sense, is a polyhedron with eight faces. Octagon, right, octa. that means eight. And in an octahedron, all the faces are triangles. Fabulous. A dodecahedron is a polyhedron with 12 faces, and all the faces on a dodecahedron are faces are pentagons. An icosahedron is a polyhedron with 20 faces, and all the faces are triangles. All right, now we have this fancy formula. Okay, so this is Euler's theorem. The number of faces, F, plus the number of vertices equals the number of edges plus 2. If it doesn't follow that rule, like if it's not true, then it's not a polyhedron. But what we're going to do is we'll just do some examples, right? So first off, we already know that this has 6 faces because we did this one over here. It has 12 edges, and it has 8 vertices. So if I plug that into the formula, F plus V, so 6 plus 8, is equal to 12 plus 2. So 6 plus 8 is 14, and 12 plus 2 is 14. Hey, it worked out. Alright, let's look at number 2. Faces. It has 5 faces. It has 9 edges, and it also has 6 vertices. So F plus V, right? F plus 6 is equal to 9 plus 2. Yep. 5 plus 6 is 11. 9 plus 2 is 11. Boom. Polyhedron. Love it. Alright, let's look at number 3 here. Faces. This guy has 7 faces and 15 edges and 10 vertices, right? F plus V, so 7 plus 10 is equal to 15 plus 2. Well, 7 plus 10, 17. 15 plus 2, 17. Alright, last one here. And we're going to use these formulas to solve this. Alright, so number 4, it has 8 faces and 18 edges, and it has 12 vertices. So F plus V, that's 8 plus 12, is equal to 18 plus 2, which it is. So 20, oh, what did I hear right there? 20 equals 10. All right, fabulous. Now we're going to talk about like some words here, right? So we have a solid that has 10 faces, 8 trapezoids, and 12 octagons. We're going to find out how many vertices it has. So how we do that is we first use that we know a trapezoid has 4 sides, right? There's 8 of them. So 8 times 4 is 32. Then we're going to calculate our octagons, right? An octagon has 8 sides. There are 2 octagons. 2 times 8 is 16. What we're going to do is we're going to add these 2 together, and then we're going to divide by 2 because there are 2 shapes. We don't want to double count the overlap, you know what I mean, where they're done connected. So 32 plus 16, that gives us 48, divide that by 2, and we have 24 edges. That's what we're trying to find, finding the edges, okay? So we know it has 10 faces, we agree with that, so F is 10. We know it now, this was the edges that we just found. Edges. So we know it has a total of 24 edges. But I don't know how many vertices it has. I know you said that we were trying to find vertices. That was last time. So I'm finding that. All right? So we're going to use Euler's rule. F plus V. So 10 plus F. Right? Because I don't know what that is. Is equal to the edges plus 2. So 24 plus 2 is 26. And if we were to solve for X, we'd say, well, it has to have 16 vertices. That's equal to 16. Alright, number 6 again. exactly like number five, and then now we have triangles and octagons, and they told us it has 14 faces. So first off, we know the faces are 14. Let's find the edges. Figure 8 triangles, we know a triangle has 3 sides, 18 faces, and 4. Octagon, we have 6 octagons, and octagon has 8 sides, 6, and 8, so 48. And add these two together. 72, and then we're going to divide that by 2, because there are, again, this solid made up of 14 faces has 2 different colors on it, too. Divide by 2, and we get 36 edges. Again, I don't know how many vertices I have, so I'm just going to put X. We know that F plus V, 14 plus X, is equal to 36. We have 2 more questions to go. Alright, number 7. A soccer ball has 32 faces. Good grief. Alright, and then it has, as far as its edges, it consists of hexagons and pentagons. Well, there's 20 hexagons. A hexagon has 6 sides. 20 times 6 is 120. And then it has 12 pentagons. 12 times 5 is 60. Alright, we add those two little numbers together. 120 plus 60, we get back to 180, divide by 2, and I get 90 edges. Oh gosh, that's a big one. Again, we're still looking for vertices. Vertices, I don't know. I'm going to put X for right now. F plus V, 32 plus X. Is equal to E plus 2. Alright, 32 plus X equals 92. Subtract 32 and I get X is equal to 60. So it has 60 vertices. Alright, number 8. Is it possible for a polyhedron to have 16 faces, 34 vertices, and 50 edges? But we're going to use Euler's rule. F plus V equals E plus 2. Let's plug it in. 16 plus 34 equals 50 plus 2. Well, 50 plus 2 doesn't mean 52. 16 plus 34, I'm going to have to cheat. What? That's 50. And 50 does not equal 52, so that's as far as you know. That's it. I don't know what home assignment number this is, because I'm all out of sorts. It's something in the 60s. But just make sure you get them all done, right? Page 746, 2 to 24, 30 to 32, and 34 and 35. Again, if you have any questions, hit me up on Schoology.